Hi guys, Kay here from Y'all Hearing This, and welcome back to another Maynard Monday. Thank you guys so much for coming back and joining us. We have been doing a little bit of everything, but figured we'd come back to Tool for this week, and we're going to do Pushit. I don't know, the name sounds so familiar to me, so I'm not sure if I've heard this before or not, but I guess we'll find out together. But anyway, I hope you guys are having a great week, and yeah, let's get into it. Some Tool, Pushit. No video for this one that I could find. I don't think I've heard it. But I really like it so far. Looks like it's descending. Oh, I love that little just how it like pulls back and then. Almost sounds like drops of water or something. I'm getting totally lost in this.
Again.
Wow. That was powerful. That was super powerful. I really like that. I love so much. Like they're so like layered. Sorry guys, I have to turn on my space heater because it's freezing in my room. I love when they just it's so much and then it just drops all the way out and then you just have these little tiny beats. Like I said, it almost sounded like little water drops kind of like falling all over. And also like listening to this with headphones is like the best always. But yeah, it oh, that was so good. All right, so I did pull up some the genius for it anyway, so let's see. All right, so it's the 11th track on their 96 sophomore effort, Enema. Wow, was that really 96? Wow. And its title is a combination of the words push and shit. Okay, I can definitely see that. One of their more lengthy and heavy tracks has been played mostly in Tool's live shows pre-Lateralis, often interchanged with a version found on Salabel. I did see there were that version too, but this seemed to be the original, so that's why I went with this. But let me know if I should do the other version too. Didn't know how different it is. Both the song and Schism seem to tackle the subject of a difficult relationship quite clearly. In this instance, only one part seems to find the relationship difficult, and they are self-diagnosing the problem while lacking the courage to tell the partner. The self-diagnosis happens mostly during the first half of the song. As the song progresses, it seems like the person is becoming more and more numb. On the final part of the song, they've entirely given up, and survival seems to be the only reason they have to go on. Now, Schism, I know I've heard that song, and I'm sorry, guys. I do have a spreadsheet of where I've kept track of like everything I've done, but I can't remember if I've actually done it on the channel or not. But if I haven't, I will at some point because I do really like that song. But yeah, it's a tough situation. Sometimes it seems like it's easier just to kind of like let status quo ride and kind of just like they're talking about survival, but I promise you that your happiness is worth more than the crap you might have to deal with, like trying to get out of something, do you know what I mean? But yeah, no, it's a tough situation. But yeah, I really like that one. I mean, musically, they're just so amazing. So yeah, you guys will definitely have to let me know similar songs. Not that they aren't all great, but you know what I mean. Yeah, definitely give me some recommendations. I can't wait to hear more. Can't wait to know more. Can't wait to see more. All that good stuff. But thank you guys so much for coming back as always, and we will see you next week.